Hi, I'm Jake.
And I'm Marie.
I'm Anna.
And we're a part of the Lunar and Planetary Science Academy, and we're going to show you all about water flow. And this is important to planetary science because channels that we're going to form today are very similar to channels that you can find on Mars and you can also find on Earth. Cut. Make them big enough for water to flow out, but they don't have to be huge gaping holes that'll put sand all over the floor. Cut. You're going to spread sand over the tray, and then be sure when you're spreading sand to not put sand over these holes, because those holes are needed for draining and the sand will clog them up. Next, after spreading the sand, we're going to put rocks in the sand to simulate different types of soil or earth that water might be flowing through. You can watch Anna and Marie excellently place rocks and bury them in the sand. And that's perfect. Next, you're going to want to make sure that your tray is elevated so that water flows out. With the two trays, you're going to want to make sure that they're elevated at different angles to simulate different slopes that water might be flowing down. This will give you slightly different channels. Both can be found on Earth and on Mars. Next, you're going to want to take your bucket and throw it right under those holes so you don't get the floor all messy. Next, we're going to pour water into the funnel. It's going to cause some channels to form.
I think we were supposed to dampen the sand first.
Watch as water slowly falls through, and when the sand gets damp enough, a channel starts. With our well-placed bucket, it's easy to clean up. I'd like to compliment Anna and Marie on their excellent job. You can watch see the stream slowly erode away the banks in the earth, and you can even see where the rocks are. It's slightly changing the shape of the banks, because those are not so easily eroded. Eventually though, some of the rocks become loose and actually start to get swept downstream. And that is science. This one, the only difference is that we got the sand wet, and the slope is much, much, much smaller. So we should see slightly different channel formation on this one. So let's have our lovely ladies do their job and pour some water down that tunnel. Look at that. Interesting.
Oh, let's just stop. I think it's saturated.
That's interesting. You can see these little islands forming. And you can see that erosion is happening a little faster on the outside of the curve than the inside of the curve. So you'll notice that this has some characteristics of a braided stream with islands forming and a stream starting it maybe in one place, but it came out and then actually reformed in some places to single channel, and channels just branched and came together, kind of like a braid. I don't know that much about braids being a male, but maybe Anna can
exactly
elaborate.
Like a brain.
Exactly, the expert came in and showed her stuff. yeah. Science. It's good for you.